Try and coax it along. It sounds ignition related, but doesn't mean it's not.
Did I screw up something in the wiring? I don't know. No one's pointing fingers, but the heat is all on me right now.
Just trying to figure out the wiring. Make sure we got it right before I go and try to start it again.
We're pulling our hair out a little bit. This car just seems to have something else come out. Every time we get two things fixed, three more break, it seems like. It's just that kind of vehicle. But it's very frustrating when you're trying to wrap up a car and you keep bumping your head against things like this. We keep running into problems that are unforeseen and shouldn't be there. Can't get frustrated at this point. You can't lose your mind. You got to focus, search your problem out, get it done. Because if we panic at this point, we go back two or three more days that we don't have.
Just make sure all my pluggies are plugged in.
Yeah, you got like a whole internet highway of wiring going on back here.
Hang on, I think I've got it.
It was definitely off. The firing order was off.
One more time. If it doesn't fire this time, I quit.
Hey! Woo!
It's alive. Sounds good.
You can kill it. Go me. It was all my fault, though.
What happened?
America, I just want y'all to know that I take full responsibility. The coil packs were wired backwards, but
hey.
But we're not out of the woods yet. The car's running. Basically, what we've got left to do is we've got to put the interior in. We've got some last minute, you know, buttoning up of, you know, fluids and things of that nature. And then we're gonna get the hood put back on it. All the things that are gonna put it on the road are the things that we need to do.
Mic check one, mic check two. Ow, now, brown cow.
So, do you guys know where Richard and Aaron are? They are always late.
I have no idea where they're at, but I'm ready to strawberry jam.
All right.
Let's go, Ricky! Come on, Ricky!
I'm coming.
Get you some of that.
Dude, we're late. The boys are gonna be pissed.
I had to get my hair right, man. And it is right.
Wow!
All right, you guys ready to rehearse?
We're out of here.
What are you leaving for? I had to do my hair.
See, he gets it.
Well, guys and gals out there in TV land, if you haven't guessed yet, we build cars at Gas Monkey Garage, and sometimes we build trucks. This time, we built a car truck. It's called an El Camino. When we first decided that we were gonna build an El Camino, we were hell-bent on finding a good one and snapped up a 1980 square body we found baking in the sun.
I didn't want to change it too much. G-bodies are popular, and that's really what this is, just less seats and more room for plywood. But the appearance definitely needed some help. First, I thought the trim was a little funky, a little weird, so I decided to ditch a lot of it, including the stuff around the outside of the bed. The next thing was the bumpers were atrocious. They were trimmed down ugly black rubber, they poked out a bunch. So one of the exterior modifications I wanted to make was actually narrowing and tucking them in. I ordered a replacement, but in the meantime, to make sure that everything was gonna work, I had the guys take the factory original bumpers and actually narrow those up to make sure that we knew exactly what we were gonna do. When the new ones got in, they sucked so bad, they went straight to the garbage. But the cool thing was, the original attempt worked out flawlessly. It was already better to look at. Next, we just had to make it fun to drive. When we bought the car, it had a V8 in it, but it was anemic. I mean, Richard and Charles couldn't even get a solid burnout in Phoenix. Come on, come on! so we had to fix that.
Oh, man, look at that.
We figured that 416 motor would get the job done, especially when we switched from an automatic to a manual transmission. And with all that power, we needed to not break the stock rear end, so we went and put a 9-inch rear end, but tabbed all for a G-body suspension so that we could install a front and rear tube, upper and lower control arms, drop spindles, big disc brakes. To complete the package, wheels. It's a lot of tire for this body style, and they absolutely rock. Now, when it came to color, we wanted to stay black-ish, but I also wanted to brush all the aluminum trim that we were keeping on the car, which is a massive undertaking, and then matte clear everything, along with the wheels and a couple other components on the engine, so the car was incredibly cohesive. So I needed something metallic and something sharp that would work with that. I was exceptionally happy when I finally saw everything painted. I love this color, the trim on the car, the wheels on the car. It finally started to make sense. Inside, we gave the dash a fresh look, and we basically took the stock seats and rebolstered them, changed the pattern on the seats the way the inserts were done, reworked the door panels completely, and this thing was ready to rumble.
So initially, I gave the guys 4 weeks to do the build, and Aaron was so confident that he said he could do it in 3.
Whoa! Ah! Things looked pretty grim when the hand of God reached out and destroyed our ability to run the paint booth via lightning strike.
We ain't got nothing.
And later, when we got everything done,
fuck,
and it didn't start.
But the guys busted their ass and they got it done, and you know what that means? Aaron won.
And you know what that means?
I have no clue.
Me either.
I was drinking during the bet. What did we bet?
I'm not sure. I think I was drunk too.
Whatever. No matter what, I still win because I tricked Aaron into getting the car built that much faster.
All in all, I think this thing from the license plate to the license plate has come together perfectly. The thing sits right, it looks right, it makes the right noise. Thing's built to move you and haul your friend too.
And since I couldn't do a burnout in Arizona, you know what I want to do, Aaron?
Tell me what you want to do, Rich.
I want to rock! Auction sale. It's just a local car guy auction. Anybody can buy anything here. So I brought the El Camino. We'll see what happens. 6-speed, cold AC, deleted all the trim.
How's it drive?
It's freaking rad. I bought the car for $8,000, and to get it to what it is today, it took about another 30 more. Toss in the lightning strike that took down the paint booth, I'm in for $42,000.
What do you expect to get out of this? What do you hope?
Between $50,000 and $75,000. We'll know in about an hour.
Let's go watch.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, coming at you next, a 1980 Chevrolet El Camino.
What do you say, 25,000? Now 25,000 I got. Now 50, 25, 50. I'm 25's in, gonna be $50,000 here to 25, 50, now 75.
So the bidding starts, and right away, I notice a pretty familiar face on the floor.
My name's Jim West from Hope, Arkansas. A couple years ago, my wife and I bought the Rolls Royce that Richard and the crew built, the Troll's Choice. And then we also picked up the 69 Riviera, both great cars. So I had to come and look at another gas monkey creation.
Are you on it at 50? You need to own it. Bid 52 back.
Here we go. 52, I'm already over the 50.
Oh, damn it. It needs to go a little higher.
No, it don't.
Yes, it does.
I'd already had my bid in, and he was trying to get me to go up. I think he was wanting me to pull a Richard and drank too much and then overspend for the car.
$51,000 here before we go.
Son of a bitch.
Last call.
Let him have it.
It'll be 51 and I have. So.
With this car for $50,000, which I think was absolutely stealing it.
You got a good deal. It's a bad dude. If you ever want to sell it, call me.
You killed it.
Excellent. Well, we're fucking done.